All right, we got SCP-3998, The Wicker Witch Lives. That's actually a homophone right there, because I didn't know which witch it was talking about. But yeah, we about to hop right into this and see which SCP this is. I have no idea what this is, so let's check it out, bro.
Candace Hayes, we have thy confession. A witch as brazen as you shall be burned at the stake. The crowd gathered in the small room bursts into a cheer as the judge hands down the sentence. The accused woman doesn't react, though. She looks neither scared nor afraid, but simply resigned to her fate. No time is to be wasted in carrying out the punishment that the judge has decreed. A pair of constables grab the woman by the arms and take her away. A mob follows along as the woman is led through the town, taunting and jeering, calling her a witch, a wife of Satan, and worse names. She doesn't seem affected by them, though. In fact, she looks as if she can't even see them. Her attention is focused solely on one mysterious woman who walks along with the crowd, and yet somehow seems disconnected, as if she isn't truly there either. The two women maintain eye contact as the constables keep pushing the condemned woman along. They lead the woman outside of town to a tall hill. The ropes binding the woman's hands are cut, and she has just a moment to rub her sore wrists before she is forced to the ground.
All right, cool. Whoa, all right. Yeah, man.
His hands are cut, and she has just a moment to rub her sore wrists before she is forced to the ground and lashed to a piece of wood as another group tosses the last logs onto a nearby pile. Once she is securely tied down, the constables step away. But then another man wearing a hood approaches. He carries a large club, and without hesitation...
Oh,
beating her legs. The woman's composure finally breaks, and she cries in pain from the cracking of her bones. The crowd only cheers louder.
And they're cheering? Wow, so yeah, this is... The human race is...
...at the screams from the witch. The beating has left the woman's legs mangled, but this is far from over. The woman, still strapped to the wood, is placed on the pyre, where she hangs like a scarecrow above the combustible material. The judge steps forward out of the screaming mob.
The beacon knocking, though.
He loudly exclaims that for her crimes, she will be burned until dead. But the judge doesn't step forward. He instead announces that another will have the honor of lighting the flame. Another man steps out of the crowd and takes the torch from the judge.
Bro. Jesus? Bro, why in the world? What? Okay.
He walks towards the pyre and looks up at the woman. She is exhausted from the beating, but she lifts her head. She doesn't look at the man with the torch, though. She's looking past him, locking eyes with the mysterious woman who walked along with the crowd. The man looks angry, slighted that she won't even meet his eyes in this final moment. And without another moment's hesitation, he tosses the torch onto the pyre. The wood lights instantly, the tinder combusting and turning into a huge roaring fire. The crowd also erupts into even louder cries of celebration as the woman screams from inside the blaze. The man watches as the woman is lost behind the fire and the smoke, and eventually...
I mean, but bro, like, back in the day, this was like people's, like, UFC, bro. This was like their boxing matches. Things like this were like the only form of entertainment. You gotta understand, people were fucked up in the crib doing absolutely nothing. So an event like this, when you condemn the evil, I don't know, I guess it's something to be celebratory to, you know?
Her cries, too, are hidden behind the crackles and pops of the flames. He doesn't move until the fire has nearly burned itself out. Most of the crowd has left at this point.
You said it wasn't entertainment, it was a hunt? What's the definition of entertainment, Donald?
And gone back to their homes, content with the role they played in doing the Lord's work. As the constables pull a charred torso down from the wood and unceremoniously toss it over a steep side of the hill, the man finally turns and starts to walk away, a tear rolling down his cheek. The judge approaches and places a hand on the man's shoulder. "There, there," the judge says, attempting to comfort the man. "You'll find a new wife soon enough."
He said, "As you wife." They go, "What would you do?"
Wow. He said, "You the coochie man."
Hundreds of people were accused of witchcraft in colonial America. And while it is...
I don't care, nigga. I'm a ride or die. What are you talking about, bro? I don't care if my shorty a witch. I ain't ratting her out. What are you talking about? That's some...
Likely that many were falsely accused. There is reason to believe that some were under the influence of, or were themselves, what we now describe as anomalies. And SCP-3998 is just such an example. Better known as the Wicker Witch Lives. SCP-3998 is a human cadaver which dates from the late 17th century that is covered in fourth-degree burns and is missing its legs. There is also evidence of extensive blunt force trauma, but it is not known if the beating or the burning was the ultimate cause of death. At some point, the remains were collected and fastened into a scarecrow that is held together with wicker, nails, and wire. While a scarecrow fashioned from a cadaver is rather unconventional, what brought SCP-3998 to the SCP Foundation's attention were its other anomalous attributes. It constantly secretes a flammable liquid from its bones that primarily consists
Yuck, of bro.
And human fat, and every night between 11 p.m. and 4 a.m., the corpse ignites. This fire doesn't cause any damage to the corpse, though, and it is unknown how it produces the flammable liquid or ignites.
Bakugo?
3998 does not keep its flames to itself, though. It appears that the SCP targets those who have either killed or physically abused a romantic partner, causing them to catch fire as large quantities of boiling ethanol appear in their stomach.
Run that back.
Targets those who have either killed or physically abused a romantic partner.
Did I hear a SCP that's low-key a hero?
Causing them to catch fire as large quantities of boiling ethanol appear in their stomach. Their midsection will eventually melt and then explode, leading to amputation of the lower half of their body. The fire burns both incredibly hot and unnaturally fast, and is unable to be put out until SCP-3998
Y'all are
is
crazy,
extinguished.
Bro.
A number of historical documents related to the case have been discovered and made available to Foundation researchers that shed light on SCP-3998, including excerpts from a 17th century diary belonging to a woman who lived near where the cadaver was discovered. In the entries, the woman describes attending the wedding of her neighbors, Aiden and Candace Hayes, though Candace did not seem especially happy with the arrangement. Candace is characterized as someone who likes to keep to herself, and who does not conform to the era's idea of the cool wife. As a result, it appears that she became the victim of abuse at the hand of her husband. The diarist hypothesizes that Candace has brought this fate upon herself due to her behavior, which may stem from her being under the hold of the devil. In other words, the neighbor believes that Candace is a witch. Others must have had the same suspicion, because we also have records of Candace's interview with a Judge William Stoughton, who questioned her about the accusations of consorting with evil spirits. Candace readily admitted to this, though she disagreed that it was in any way evil. She told the judge that the rituals and magics she practiced were not inherently good or bad, and that anyone was capable of using the same tools. She went on to explain that she hated her...
I feel like if you ever time travel, bro, with some technology, bro, it's over. It is over.
...husband, that she had been forced to marry him, and that he had been nothing but cruel and violent towards her. Candace also mentioned a name, Clovis, that the judge assumed to be the demon that she had made her cursed pact with. Candace appeared to offer no defense or excuses for her actions, and the judge sentenced her to die by burning at the stake, with her husband, Aiden, being the one to light the fire.
Crazy, bro.
The story of this witch trial was typical of the time, and that likely would have been the end of what we know about SCP-3998. But another historical document was located that has truly given a new perspective to this anomaly. A sealed letter found in the cellar of a home that is addressed to Candace, though it appears to have been written after her death. The letter is from her secret lover, and describes how they collected Candace's burnt bones from the bottom of the hill before binding them together with wicker and wire. The letter then describes how Candace's husband has recently restocked his own home with gin, which is well known to be extremely flammable. The letter ends with an affirmation of the writer's eternal love for Candace and is signed, Clovis.
Oh, she was like those. Okay, I understand.
But perhaps the best information we have about the origin of SCP-3998 comes from an obscure local tale that was passed down orally for years and eventually documented on an urban legend website.
The legend tells of a woman who promised her soul to a she-devil who taught her magic, but also offered companionship. When her husband found out, he contacted the local authorities and had the woman arrested. She was tried, her legs were broken.
Oh, so he was mad that his chick was stolen by another chick. Hey, yo, okay.
And she was hung up like a scarecrow before
being... Why do niggas be hating, bro? All right, bro, your girl don't want you no more, bro. Just move on. It is what it is, bro.
Burned alive. Her body was dumped off the side of a mountain, but the she-devil collected her bones and gave her life again. The need for revenge burned in the woman's heart, so in the middle of the night, she doused herself in her husband's gin, set herself on fire once more, and fell upon him as he slept, burning him alive. So he could suffer the way that she did. SCP-3998 is currently held in a secure holding locker in Site 34 that is fireproofed and vacuum sealed to prevent it from igniting. Every morning at 9 a.m., 3998 and its locker are cleaned to remove the secretions of flammable liquid. D-class personnel who have been convicted of domestic abuse crimes are to always be kept at the site to ensure that they are the targets of SCP-3998, which, when it's not allowed to ignite, will result in them only feeling mild discomfort in their head and chest rather than spontaneous combustion. Due to its relatively easy method of containment, SCP-3998 has been classified as safe. However, recent developments have caused the Foundation to rethink this classification. Despite 3998 being securely contained, the number of arson-related homicides in the state of Massachusetts have actually increased following containment, with many showing the same damage to their body as would be expected in a victim of SCP-3998. And while it may be that these are the result of a yet uncaught serial killer who simply happens to employ similar methods of killing their victims, a recent re-examination of the SCP-3998...
I ain't gonna lie, I'ma keep it honest with y'all, bro. I was looking at Dr. Bob, bro. The lighting that he has don't make no sense, bro. His face should be fully revealed. But anywho.
Corpse has revealed more troubling details. The body of SCP-3998 does not belong to Candace Hayes, and in fact appears to be a male who was in his 30s at the time of his death. Following these new revelations, reclassification of SCP-3998 to Euclid is pending. Whether SCP-3998 is the body of Candace's husband Aiden, forced to endure an eternal punishment of burning again each and every night, or if it's some other unfortunate victim of a violent and painful death, is unknown. As is the ultimate fate of Candace and Clovis. But with the deaths that would appear to be attributable to SCP-3998 showing no signs of stopping despite containment, it can only be assumed that the Wicker Witch lives. Now go and watch another entry from the files of Dr. Bob, and be sure to subscribe as we delve further and further into the SCP Foundation's classified archives.
Shout out Dr. Bob, bro. He's been going crazy with these uploads, bro. It's probably like, he probably got a team. Either that or he'd be working overtime, bro. Yeah, shout out to him, bro. I mean, this story was crazy, bro. This story was crazy. I ain't gonna lie, bro.